How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today we're going to be talking about three of the best VPNs for Chengdu, China. So before we begin, if you guys are interested in any of the VPNs mentioned today, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs. So if you're going to China or if you're already there, one thing many like to do is obviously use the internet. But if you've forgotten that China is a communist country, you'll definitely remember it quickly if you try to use the internet. China's Great Firewall is known for being one of the, most restrictive firewalls around the world. That is why using a VPN to get around censorship is very important. The truth is, the government censors the internet. Now, connect to a VPN server in another country to encrypt your data and unblock websites, and you're good to go. The next great reason to use a VPN in China is to protect your privacy. The country's internet policy does not end at the massive firewall. Instead, the Chinese government admits they monitor all internet traffic. And by using a VPN, you make it much harder for others to compromise your data or track your movements. Keep in mind that if the Chinese government really wants your information, they won't hesitate to use any methods available. And to restrict such methods, you want to use a reliable, true no-lock policy VPN. And that will be definitely my best choice would be ExpressVPN, though NordVPN and Surfshark do work. I would suggest that you, if you're in China, if you're living in China, just go with ExpressVPN. And if you're outside of China, you can download any of these VPNs, though you want to make sure you take the correct measures. So with ExpressVPN, you don't need to do anything. Download it and you're good to go. With NordVPN, you want to make sure you're downloading the correct version, which works in censorship-heavy countries. So you can ask either the live chat support for the link, or you can look it up yourself. There is a version of NordVPN that works in censorship-heavy countries. And the one I have right now, for example, this one does not. I'm not in a censorship-heavy country, so I don't need the other version. But the other version will be needed if you're in a censorship-heavy country. And with Surfshark, if no borders mode doesn't work, you're going to have to do some manual tweaking or configuration in order to make it work in China. So yeah, thanks to the government censorship and the CCP just keeping a tight grip on internet traffic, using a VPN when in Chengdu or any other city in China really is a definite must. From getting around the Great Firewall to stopping prying eyes, VPN providers have you covered, especially with these three VPNs. And, you know, for me personally, if you're in a censorship-heavy country, I would just stick to ExpressVPN. I would not advise that you compromise on your security and privacy, especially if you're living in such a restrictive country or in a communist country or socialist country. You want to make sure that you delete your tracks and keep your data masked with an IP that is not yours, so that you don't risk getting harassed by the government or authorities. Okay, so how do you know which one of these VPNs could be the best choice for you? Well, it depends on what you're looking for out of the VPN. Now, ExpressVPN has over 3,000 servers in 94 countries and will allow you to secure up to 5 devices per subscription. ExpressVPN has basic features such as the internet kill switch, which is called network lock in Express, and split tunneling. Now, if you're not familiar with these, the kill switch will make sure that you're only connected to the internet when you're secured by the VPN. So if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly, it will also disconnect your internet connection, making sure that you don't connect back to the ISP servers, making sure that you don't connect back to your internet service provider's servers, and only be connected through the VPN secured servers. Now, split tunneling will allow you to choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not. So you could only have, for example, your torrenting client routed through the VPN while the rest of your network is left intact or untouched by the VPN connection, or the other way around, where you could have select applications bypass the VPN connection while the rest of your network is secured by the VPN. Okay, so let's say you're looking for a VPN that is a little bit more budget friendly, and that would be NordVPN with over 5,100 servers in 60 countries. Now, even though NordVPN has 34 less countries than ExpressVPN, as you can tell, it is still quite the number at 60 countries. You'll be able to secure up to 6 devices per subscription though, and a whole bunch of security features such as specialty servers, as you can tell here, with a dedicated IP, double VPN, onion over VPN, and peer-to-peer. And of course, you've got an ad blocker right here, and the very quick and best performing protocol, Nord Lynx. Keep in mind, when you switch to Nord Lynx, you will lose access to double VPN and dedicated IP. And unless you need these specific specialty servers, I would just recommend that you stick to Nord Lynx, which is a very quick protocol. In fact, so quick that you don't want to use anything else. Not only do you get the conventional kill switch, but you also get the app kill switch, which will close selected apps when you disconnect from the VPN or the connection drops, rather than disconnecting your entire connection as it is with the conventional kill switch. Split tunneling. You've got also custom DNS, which is an easy way to change your DNS, and obfuscated servers if you're in a censorship heavy country. Now, if you're looking for the most budget friendly VPN, that would be Surfshark. Surfshark has over 3,200 servers in 65 countries, which makes it a very convenient option for those wanting to secure a whole bunch of devices with just one subscription, because it will allow you to virtually secure an unlimited number of devices with just one subscription. And it being such a budget-friendly VPN, without necessarily sacrificing much on security, performance, or features for that matter, makes it a very enticing VPN for most people, especially those that don't want to spend a whole lot, at least on their first VPN experience. So you still get multi-hop and static IP, which are the same as double VPN and dedicated IP from NordVPN. And if you don't know what these are, by the way, static IP will give you, well, static IP addresses, which means that these servers have IPs that are set and do not change. Multi-hop will route your connection through two servers, as you can tell, rather than one, for double the protection, making it extra difficult to track you. And in these settings here, you will notice that we still get whitelister, which is split tunneling, it's just called whitelister here, the kill switch, an ad blocker, as well as a handful of protocols. For the most part, you just want to use the best performing protocol. Again, that'll be the WireGuard protocol. It's so quick that you don't want to use anything else. You've got IKEV2, which is a good protocol. It's pretty quick. Extra security will be offered by OpenVPN, both UDP and TCP, and Shadow Socks will help you reach banned websites if you're in a censorship-heavy country, though it will only secure your browser traffic, so keep that in mind, and No Borders Mode will help you bypass the Great Firewall of China if you are in China or any other censorship-heavy country for that matter. And, you know, if you notice that ExpressVPN doesn't really have any obfuscated kind of options here for obfuscation and whatnot, that's because ExpressVPN actually has obfuscation on by default. It's always on, and you don't have to go through any sort of configuration or toggle any kind of option in order to turn it on. All you have to do is download it and it will work whether you're in China, outside of China, in any other censorship heavy country, it doesn't matter. That's of course part of the ease of use with ExpressVPN. So that'll be it for this video, guys. Keep in mind that all these VPNs are covered by a 30-day money-back guarantee. So no matter which VPN you decide to go for, you'll be able to claim the refund. Let me just show you guys very quickly. So if I go ahead and get ExpressVPN, you'll notice that all these VPNs, it says there are 30-day money-back guarantees on them. So even if you just go for the one-month plan, you will be able to claim the refund through the 24/7 live chat support. By the way, it's the same with NordVPN and Surfshark. All you need to do is hover over the bottom right and you'll be able to access the live chat support, the 24/7 live chat support, where they will help you with your refund or any other question you might be having about these VPNs. Again, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below for all of these VPNs. And you'll also find full reviews that'll give you more of an in-depth look into the privacy policy, speed streaming, and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. So be sure to check those out if you guys are interested. That'll be it for this video. Comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.